over my years of setting these up and recording these, they never feel any less like a weird exhibitionist thing. As promised, earlier today on Twitter, I said that I needed to record a video just explaining my feelings and frustrations, but let's go back a bit. I've been gainfully employed in the IT field, a software support position, for the last nearly 8 years. I've gotten really good at what I do. I've gotten comfortable with what I do. That being said, management changes over the years forced me into thinking about my future. I had recently become single and thought, I'll go back to school and finally follow up on my dream to move to Japan, get that degree and just leave. It's a great idea. So I have been back in school now for 2 years. Management changes swung back around. Suddenly I'm being managed well again. Got more comfortable with the position. So I've been biding my time. I don't enjoy software support like I once did, because now I'm a higher level tech, lots of knowledge and skill, and I'm really good at difficult customers. So big profile cases get passed over to me. I handle the tough stuff. And because of that, it's caused me to become very jaded and just angsty about the whole thing. Every day I go to work and I can expect something to go horribly wrong. Some case is going to pass my desk and it's going to be a nightmare. Oh, by the way, I did not dress up for this whole occasion. I'm wearing glasses for the first time in about a year, and I look like crap. This haircut requires a lot of maintenance, and I haven't done that at all since I got home from work today. It was a bit of a stressful day. So the last 2 days, it's really culminated in difficult cases at work after difficult case after difficult case. Stuff you don't want to deal with. Stuff you don't want to deal with. And normally I get a steady flow of simple cases among the tough ones, and it keeps my drive going. It keeps me sane. Not happy, but it keeps me sane. I can do my job. But this week has just not been that. So difficult case on difficult case on difficult case. And now I go forward to, I have to go in tomorrow and deal with another high profile case that's already on my desk waiting for me. Yeah! And it's one that I'm powerless to stop. I don't want to get into those details because it's employer specific, and it doesn't shine well on me for to complain about that kind of thing. If my employer watches this video, hi, I'm okay. Don't worry about me. So mostly what I'm all about right now is the stress of work. Now, at the end of April, school let out, so I'm not stressed about school anymore. For now, passed all my classes, 3 A's and a C, and the C was in accounting, and I knew I was going to do bad in accounting, so fine by me. So I finished my last final April 28th, went through the weekend. I spent a floating holiday that I got that Monday. And then Tuesday, May 1st, was my flight out of the U.S. I flew through Canada to Japan. Dream vacation. I spent what I can only call the best 2 weeks of my life there. And it's unfortunate that I have to say that, because that trip had, it was supposed to be my grounding post. I was supposed to say, hey, Japan is just a place like any other. It might have a certain charm, but there's nothing so special that you need to speed through years of your life facing insurmountable depression and school and nonsense just so you can take a huge pay cut to go teach English in a foreign country. Now that I've been there, things are very different. I fell in love. I fell in love hard. I found my home. That place felt so right. I felt good about it. So now I'm stuck back at home. And while I'm not taking classes through the summer, I am working through the summer. And I have to face that every day. I don't know what I'm going to do, because now I have another 3 semesters. That's a year and a half, plus however long it takes to pay off most of school and get my stuff together to move out of the country. So stress, right? That is something that I now have to feel away from what I feel my goal is. And I know the last 2 years I've complained and suffered through that, but now it's tangible, it's real. I've seen it, I've felt it. I want that. And now the further bad news. Work has gotten more complicated now. Since I've been there for nearly 8 years, and I've shown to my managers that I don't want to take on the higher level positions because it takes away the things I'm good at and it puts me in a position where I'm just kind of floundering. I don't want to get promoted past the point of usefulness. I've seen it happen too many times. I don't want to be that guy. So I've stagnated. I've kept it. At least I drew the line. I said, I want to at least graduate school before I make a decision to move on. I'm making ends meet. I'm comfortable. Everything is okay. Well, it seems that that wasn't enough for my boss. She, and I'm hoping it's in a kind light and a kind heart that she has spurned on changes to my position. And she has put my name in, or well, with my approval, she put my name in to move on to a developer position. Now, unfortunately, there are no developer positions open right now, so a technical analyst position is the only thing I have to move to right now. And they're very adamant that I should do that. And yes, I may get more money out of it, but I don't know. It's uncertain. I don't know what this position is going to be like. Am I going to work for a good manager? Is it going to be a position I hate? And what happens then? Do I leave the company and leave my future up to who knows what? I can't imagine that. I've known the stability of having the same work for nearly 8 years now. I kind of cling to that. I need that in my life. So I'm aggressively frustrated. I now know that without a doubt, I suffer from pretty bad anxiety. I never really thought I did until I went back to school. Now every day is just anxiety. I get nervous if somebody even says, "Hey, can I talk to you for a minute?" That's enough to just set me off and ruin a day. That is no good. So I haven't had much time since I got back from my trip, nearly exactly a week ago. I had guests over right at the end of the trip. The next day, they were here for 3 days, just staying, not like they were high maintenance or anything. But it was just the fact that I was hosting people. And then the weekend rolls in, road trip, D&D game. Oh, you're back at work now. There's been no decompression time. I haven't stopped worrying, thinking. And now at work, I go to work. I hate the cases and the stress and all the nightmarish. But now also combined with the uncertainty of my job future. And that, it took a dear friend of mine great effort to make me leave my last job, which I hated. And he got me in contact with the person who got me the job I'm at now. And that was an amazing move, but the stress that I went through during that move almost killed me. And now here I am facing another one in the middle of school. My future is turmoil. I'm going to do my best and I'm going to do great at it. But my future is turmoil. Thanks for listening in. This is the rant I wanted to do on Twitter, but 240 characters is not enough for that. I have Japanese practice in about an hour, so I'm going to edit this video, upload it really quick. My camera is dying, so I'm going to call it here. Peace.